and Snake Farm, and Jared Forthman joins me, and you are holding a bouncing baby girl, right?
Yes, that's right. This is Tango.
Hi, Tango.
And Tango is an Australian dingo.
A dingo. Okay.
That's right.
I got to tell you, if at first glance I would think, oh, there's a dog wandering around.
That's right. Yeah, you kind of would. She definitely doesn't behave like your normal domestic dog, though. Mm-hmm. This is kind of Australia's version of our coyote, so to speak. So
she's like kangarooing your stomach.
Yeah, absolutely. She's definitely very personable and just absolutely loves being held. But one thing that makes her so much different than like your normal domestic dogs is they don't bark. She will occasionally make some vocalizations, but she's never going to be yapping a whole lot. But before you start thinking, hey, right, I need one of those as a pet at
right
home. One, it's illegal, but two is they don't train so high.
Okay,
so
they kind of do what they want to do,
yeah,
what instinct tells them
that's
to do.
That's right, and she is constantly teething right now.
Uh-huh.
That's why she keeps reaching back to bite me.
Ah,
but,
so lots of chew toys and things like that. So how big is she going to get?
Go ahead and set her down here. She's going to get up to about 60, 65 pounds at full grown. And so really it's about just the same size as our coyotes that we have here in the United States.
And I'm noticing this kind of tuft of hair here, this mane.
That's right.
Which is very in right now.
That's right. That mohawk she's got there, where a lot of domestic dogs, you'll notice they raise the hair on their back when they're angry or scared or something like that. Tango here is going to raise that hair when she gets really excited. So whenever she's coming out to play like this, she raises that hair up.
Now, how fast do they move? Are they pretty quick? Or?
They are pretty quick. They are one of Australia's biggest carnivores and predators that they have there. Matter of fact, this is their biggest mammal predator of all.
So what would they hunt?
They're going to hunt pretty much anything that moves that they can catch.
Okay.
So anything from small kangaroo, wallabies, to a wide variety of reptiles. And unfortunately in Australia, there is a big problem with these guys getting onto farms and taking advantage of easy prey on livestock.
Uh-huh.
Matter of fact, that's so much a problem that they've built a fence almost across the whole continent there to help keep these guys out of more civilized areas.
Being from Australia, I'm assuming they do well in the heat?
Yeah, she does really well out here in the heat. She's on display out here all day long, and she comes out for a lot of our different educational shows. This is one of the many animals that customers or guests do have hands-on opportunities with.
She's very friendly.
Yeah, I think like, she left us a little odor and then traveled away like she didn't do that.
She crop dusted.
Yeah.
She crop dusted. So you mentioned a little bit interactive with.
Yeah, absolutely. So we have her out just not for our educational programs that are around the clock here during the summer, but also for our birthday parties. This is one of our many animals that comes out for interaction with our birthday boy or girls. And this is probably one of the favorites of the kiddos. For obvious reasons.
She's smiling all the time. Oh, hey, who's that? All right, for more information on Animal World and Snake Farm and, of course, birthday parties that they do here, and come on out here and meet Tango. Just head to our website, salive.com, and click on the As Seen on SA Live tab.